Now we have to see about the electron transport chain of chloroplast. In the chloroplast, electrons are transported from one hydrogen acceptor to another hydrogen acceptor. During the transport of electrons, energy-rich compounds are produced. Assimilatory powers are generated. ATP, that is the ATP. ATP synthesis takes place, and also NADPH plus H plus taking place. These two energy-rich compounds are generated during the electron transport chain of chloroplast. Electron transport chain in each photosystem involves four complexes. Photosystem is of two types, I told you. Photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. In these two photosystem, there are four complexes present. Number 1, core complex, that is referred as CC. Number 2, light harvesting complex or antenna complex, that is referred as LHC. The third one is cytochrome B6F complex, and fourth one is ATPase complex or coupling factor. One by one we will see. The first one is core complex, that is referred as in short CC. The CC consists of CC1 and CC2. CC1 is in PS1, pigment system 1, where the reaction center is P700. CC2 is in pigment system 2, that is PS2, where the reaction center is P680. So that is the core complex, core complex 1 and core complex 2. The second complex, light harvesting complex or antenna complex, it is referred as LHC, light harvesting complex. It is of two types, LHC1 in that is present in the PS1 and LHC2 that is present in the PS2. Come to the third complex, cytochrome B6F complex. It is a non-pigmented protein complex connecting PS1 and PS2. Plastoquinone PQ and plastocyanin PC are intermediate complexes acting as a mobile or shuttle electron complexes. They are the carriers of electron transport. So, there are two intermediate complexes are there. One is PQ, plastoquinone, another one is plastocyanin. They are acting as a mobile electron carriers of electron transport chain or shuttle electron carriers of electron transport chain. PQ acts as a shuttle between PS2 and cytochrome B6F, cytochrome B6F complex, and PC connects cytochrome B6F and PS1 complex. The fourth one is ATPase complex or coupling factors. It is found in the surface of the thylakoid membrane. This complex is made up of CF1 and CF0 factor. Already I told you CF means coupling factor. Coupling factor 1 and coupling factor 0. This complex utilizes energy from ETC, electron transport chain, and converts ADP and inorganic phosphate, PI, into ATP, that is the energy-rich compound or assimilated power. Synthesis of ATP, production of ATP, that is called phosphorylation. Phosphorylation is of several types. Number one, oxidative phosphorylation. Second, substrate level phosphorylation. And third one, photophosphorylation. First, oxidative phosphorylation. Phosphorylation takes place during respiration, during the oxidation of food material, energy liberated, and that is used for the formation of ATP, that is called oxidative phosphorylation, that is taking place only respiration. Only in respiration that is taking place. And ATP produced by the breakdown of substrate is known as the substrate level phosphorylation. And third one is photophosphorylation. In addition to phosphate, here takes place with the help of light generated electron, and so it is called photophosphorylation. You can see this. During photosynthesis, phosphorylation takes place in the electron with the help of light generated electron. This is called photophosphorylation. So what is photophosphorylation? When the formation of ATP, synthesis of ATP takes place in the presence of light during photosynthesis, that is called photophosphorylation. Photophosphorylation is of two types, cyclic photophosphorylation and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. The cyclic photophosphorylation and non-cyclic photophosphorylation we'll see in the next clause in detail. So, in this clause, we have seen the electron transport chain, the functions of the electron transport chain as four complexes, core complex, light harvesting complex, cytochrome B6 and F complex, ATPase complex or coupling factors. That's all.